donuts. Get your eating, drink on.
International recording artist Mia X has had the eloquent, lyrical chops of a rapper since she debuted on Master P's No Limit Records in 1984. But chops refers to more than music, as Mia X is also a tour de force in the kitchen, especially when it comes to gumbo.
I like to add vinegar to like neutralize the slime, and adding the vinegar, we still keep all the nutritional values of okra. No slime.
Food is family for Mia X, and her family is well known in New Orleans.
My Aunt Mary used to make the gumbo for Dickie Chase. My grandmother, the thing she did with us was get us in the kitchen and, you know, chop that onion, chop that garlic, wash that chicken. But then she would be asking us stuff like, well, what's going on in school? Our kitchen was like the therapist's couch.
There's a history of musicians doubling as cooks that goes back far and includes the likes of Louis Armstrong, who was known for his red beans and rice recipe.
Most of us grow up, especially artists in the South, we grow up cooking. Aretha Franklin used to go into the hotels and cook in their kitchen.
Over the years, Mia X has cooked for an array of artists that includes Monica, Kelly Price, Trina, Betty Wright, Busta Rhymes, and all of the No Limit soldiers.
I put my first record out 30 years ago. I've been stirring pots for my colleagues for a long time, and that makes me feel so good to hear them say they like the food.
But it's more than the rich and famous that enjoys Mia's food. Every year, she celebrates a birthday in New Orleans by feeding the disadvantaged, a lesson that was given to her by her grandmother. Recently, she launched her own line of seasoning and a cookbook, all about her music career, her family, her food, and life's lessons.
My grandmother put a pound of red beans on every single day, and that was for anybody in our neighborhood that was hungry. The food is what brought us together. When the women in our family went through something, a lot of times they would wash and cut up chicken, and you would know when something was really going on because sometimes the freezer would just be full of chicken.